recording. Okay. Fine. Good morning to one another.
Morning, sir.
Okay, last class we have seen the positive shunt clipper with positive reference voltage. Similarly, a positive shunt clipper with the negative reference voltage. Okay. Yeah, this is a positive reference voltage and this is a negative reference voltage. Okay. As I said that there are totally around 16 circuits. Okay. And it is very difficult to remember the each and every circuit. Okay. Therefore, by according to the title, you have to draw the circuit. Okay, you can draw it by your own by seeing the title itself. Okay. I have said that here negative shunt clipper. Negative shunt clipper means the negative portion of the input signal has to be cut down. Okay, negative portion has to be cut down. Okay. And also I have said negative reference voltage. Okay, negative reference voltage means the negative terminal has to be connected to the diode. Okay, negative terminal has to be connected to the diode. That means first negative shunt. That means negative cycle in the input. Negative cycle has to be cut down. Okay, if it is a shunt clipper, when the diode is on. And in that case, the output will be clipped. Okay. That means in the negative cycle, diode has to be on. Okay. Like that, you have to assume. Okay. Then you can draw the circuit by your own. Okay. Now I am explaining how to draw the circuit without bypassing the circuit. Okay. By seeing the title itself, you can draw it. Okay. If it is a negative shunt clipper, means negative portion has to be cutted. Means in shunt, when the diode is on, the portion will be cutted. Okay, when the diode is on, at that time, whether it is a series also. Okay, if it is a series clipper also, if the diode is on, output is zero. Okay, that means output is clipped. Okay, output is cutted. Therefore, when the diode is on, we are going to cutting the our waveform. We are going to cutting the our output waveform. We are clipping the output waveform. Okay, therefore. Negative clipper means negative cycle diode has to be on. In negative cycle diode has to be on means if it is input, if it is on, your one terminal is zero. Must ensure one terminal is connected to the ground. Therefore, negative cycle means negative has to be connected that side. Okay. Therefore, it may become say one negative series clipper. Okay? If diode is connected in this case, here we are giving -1, -2, -3, so on, and it is zero. In that case only diode will be on. Therefore, in negative cycle, diode is on. Negative cycle diode is on. Positive cycle diode will be off. Therefore, we may get a positive output. Okay. Therefore, by seeing the title, okay, here also negative cycle diode has to be on. Therefore, negative cycle means therefore we are connecting to the cathode. Okay. We are connecting to the cathode. Therefore, diode will be on only in negative cycle. The chances of making this diode on in only negative cycle. Positive cycle definitely it will be off. Okay. Positive cycle it will be off. Therefore, by seeing the negative shunt, therefore we have to place the shunt and negative. Therefore, cathode is connected to the input. If it is a positive shunt, the anode will be connected to the input. If it is a series, then we are going to place it here. Okay, we are going to place it here. If it is a shunt, we are placing here. Therefore, by seeing this part, okay, we are going to fixing this one. We are going to fixing the diode. And then after, if we have a reference, if we won't have a reference, directly we are connecting to the ground. Then if we have a reference, okay, if we have a reference, negative reference means negative terminal should be connected to the diode. Negative terminal should be connected to the diode. And positive is grounded. This will be your ground terminal. Okay, positive is grounded. Negative is connected to the diode. Okay, like that, you can draw the circuit. Okay, no need to by heart. Okay. You by seeing the title itself, you can, because there are total 16 clipping circuits. Okay. All the 16 clipping circuits by hearting means it is very difficult. Okay. Therefore, by seeing the title, you can draw. Okay. We will see another circuit also. Okay. Here I have said negative shunt. Okay. Negative shunt clipper with positive reference. Okay. Negative shunt means it has to be cut the negative portion. It has to be cut the negative portion. And positive cycle diode has to be on. Okay, positive cycle diode has to be on. Okay, when it is on, negative cycle diode has to be on. I think so. Here, your circuit is wrong. title may be wrong. This may be pause to shunt. Okay, I have keep the title wrong. Pause to shunt. Okay, therefore in pause to cycle. Okay, diode will be on. No, it is right only. Okay, negative shunt means we have to cut the output waveform. In negative pulse has to be cut. Okay, once you will see it. Yeah, by seeing the title. Okay, here I have said negative shunt. Negative shunt means negative cycle has to be cut down. Output should not get the any negative pulse. Therefore, when the diode is on, the negative pulse will be cutted. Okay, therefore diode has to be on in negative cycle. Okay, if you want to on in negative cycle means this will be cathode. Okay, and this will be anode. Like this, diode has to be placed like this. Okay, diode has to be placed like this. Then when it is a negative cycle, diode will be on. Diode is on. Okay. Diode is on. It is a positive reference. Positive reference, therefore, positive is connected to the diode. Positive terminal is connected to the diode. Here, diode symbol is wrong. Okay, diode symbol is wrong. Okay, therefore, when you apply a positive cycle, diode will be off. Diode will be off because it is a cathode. It is a cathode. We are applying positive, therefore, diode will be off. And we are going to get the output is the positive one. Okay, output we are going to get the positive cycle. Okay, now when we are applying negative cycle, we are getting the this will be in forward bias. Negative cycle, it will be forward bias, and we may have this reference voltage. Here we have a reference voltage, therefore we are going to get reference voltage. And if we won't have the reference voltage, we are getting the zero voltage. Okay, therefore by seeing the circuit, you can draw the diagram. Okay, I think so. You have to understand how to draw the diagrams. By seeing here, diode is reversed. Okay, in this circuit, diode is reversed. Okay, negative shunt means the negative portion has to be connected to the input. Okay, like this you have to draw. Okay, and now we will start our session. 1 minute, I am going to lock in your room from onwards. No participant can join the class. Therefore, now you can use your cameras or you can switch off your cameras. I have locked your room. Okay, if you leave the class, it is not possible to join the class. Okay, therefore see that your net signal should be proper. Okay, now we will go to the last class. Okay, last class we have seen the positive shunt and positive shunt with negative reference. These two cases we have seen. Okay, positive shunt with positive reference, positive shunt with negative reference. Now we will see the negative shunt clipper. Okay, negative shunt clipper. Here you can observe that this circuit is wrong. Okay, because the positive shunt diode is in like this. In negative shunt also, I have placed the diode in same manner. Therefore, the diode in this diagram, diode is, this is right. Okay, here, negative shunt, we have taken the diode in right position. Okay, in this circuit diagram, the diode symbol is wrong. Okay, diode symbol is wrong. I think so, while making the PPT, I had pasted the positive shunt here. Okay, I have placed the positive shunt in respect of the negative shunt. Okay, here, the diode symbol will be reverse. Okay, that means this will be your cathode. Okay, and this will be your anode. Okay, diode will be in this manner. Okay, diode will be in this manner. Okay, keep in mind in negative shunt in PPT, diode symbol is reversed. Okay, therefore, this is your circuit diagram. And coming to the explanation, has the title of negative shunt clipper with positive reference. Okay, negative shunt clipper means in negative pulse, that means. When the input is negative, diode has to be on. Okay. When the negative pulse is occurring, diode has to be on means negative has to be connected to your cathode. Okay. Therefore, cathode is on top side. Okay. Therefore, when you apply the negative pulse, this diode will be on. This diode will be on and it is going to clip it. Negative pulse will be clipped. Now we have connected a positive reference. Positive reference means Positive terminal is connected to the diode. Positive terminal is connected to the diode. Now we will see the explanation how it is. When you are at zero volts, anode is at, suppose this reference voltage may be 2 volts. Reference voltage may be 2 volts DC. And our AC waveform or our sinusoidal waveform is +5 to -5. Okay, +5 to -5. Okay, when we are at zero terminal, okay. Anode is at 2 volts, cathode is at 0. Therefore, if we observe the condition, that is cathode potential is less than the anode potential. Therefore, diode will be in on state. Okay, diode will be in on state. Okay, therefore diode is on means the output waveform will be clipped. Therefore this waveform, okay, this if you see the output, okay, the starting we have clipped, okay, our input waveform at the starting we had clipped up to the reference voltage. Suppose this is your reference voltage level 2, okay, 2 volts. This is your 5 volts, okay. Therefore up to the 2 volts the output has been clipped. Why? Because it is clipped. You suppose here it is 1 volt, okay, we are in positive cycle, okay, we are at 1 volt and cathode is at 1 volt, anode is at 2 volts. Therefore diode is in on position only. When the diode is on, the signal will pass through this side, okay, therefore output will be 0, okay, therefore output is clipped, okay. When it is 2.1, if I say that it is a ideal diode, when it is 2.1, okay, now cathode potential is more than the anode potential. Anode is fixed at 2 volts, cathode is at 2.1, therefore cathode potential is more than the anode potential. Therefore in this case diode is in off state. When diode is off, this is an open circuit. Therefore total input will goes to the output, total input will comes to the output. Therefore from the 2 or from 2.1, the whatever the input we are getting at the output terminal, okay, and reaches to 5 volts and again starts decreasing and again it reaches to the 2 volts. Again it may reaches to the 2 volts. When it is 1.9, when our input voltage is 1.9, again in that case anode is 1.9, cathode is 1.9, anode is at 2 volts. Therefore again anode voltage is less than the cathode voltage. Therefore diode is on. Again therefore this portion will be cutted or this portion will be clipped. Similarly for negative pulses also. Yeah, negative minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, so on. Okay. Anode is at 2 volts and cathode is at less than the anode voltage, minus voltages. Therefore, diode will be on and entire input voltage will pass through the diode and to the ground. Okay, here you may have the ground signal. Okay, therefore it will be grounded. Okay, therefore output will be 0. Therefore, entire negative cycle is also clipped. Okay, entire output will be clipped. Therefore, we are going to get the output only in above the reference values. Above the reference level. If the reference level is to above this level only, we are going to get the output. Below that level, we are going to get the 0 voltage. We are clipping the negative cycle and a portion in positive also going to be clipped if we apply a positive reference voltage. Okay, therefore output will be in this manner. Okay, I think so you have to understand. Okay, if the input is varying, time to time, when the diode will be on, output is going to be clipped. Okay, output will be 0 volts. Okay, because the signal present here will cease the two parts. Here we are connected a load resistance and here it is a short circuit part having less resistance. Therefore, entire signal will pass through the diode only when diode is on. When it is off, it is an open circuit. Therefore, here a high impedance will be formed and the total signal will go to the output terminal. Okay, I think so you have to understand this concept. If we are considered as a practical, okay, cathode is at 2 volts. Okay, when the cathode voltage is at 2.1, okay, there generally if I take it as a silicon, okay, if I take it as silicon diode, then the cutout voltage may be 0.7. Therefore, there should be a difference of 0.7. Okay, when the input voltage reaches to the 2.7 volts. Okay, when input voltage reaches to the 2.7, when it is 2.8 volts. Okay, when 2.8 volts this side, then the cathode is higher than the anode. Okay, that 0.7 difference is nothing but a cutdown voltage. Therefore, I had mentioned here VR minus, that is reference voltage minus cutdown voltage. Okay, there is a difference of this cutdown voltage if you consider the practical diode. There will be difference of this cutdown voltage, 0.7 for a silicon and 0.3 for germanium. Okay, this difference we are going to see. Okay, if we take ideal, similarly we may have only VR. Okay, we will have only VR voltage. Okay, yeah, that means this diode will be on immediately when it passes to the 0 volts. Okay. That's it. If you see the transfer characteristics, when the input voltage is less than VR, that means 1.2, 1.3, for same example, if it is 2 volts, when it is 1.2, 1.3, diode will be on state. Therefore, when diode is on means this 2 volts is connected in parallel with our output. Therefore, output will be maintained at reference voltage. Therefore, output will be maintained constant. Output is maintained constant until this voltage crosses this voltage. Okay. Therefore, because diode is in on state. Therefore, here you are going to have a short circuit and 2 volts is connected to the output terminal. Therefore, it will be maintained. Okay. That means in positive. Okay. Positive as the voltage reaches to the reference value. Suppose this may be our reference level. If at this time period, up to this time period, you are going to, that means you can consider from the origin. Okay. This is negative cycle. From the origin. Okay. This is our origin. From origin. Okay, we are going to maintain a constant voltage because diode is on state. Therefore, up to this portion, we are going to having a constant. Okay, this is the output. Okay, output will be maintained constant. Okay, when it crosses the cutdown voltage, as the input increases, output also increases. Therefore, we may get a linear. Okay, this is in positive cycle. Okay, while coming to the negative cycle, diode will be in off state only. Therefore, we are maintaining a constant voltage. We negative cycle, you can observe in output waveform also. Negative cycle, the diode will be in on state. Okay, diode will be in on state. Therefore, this 2 volts is fixed to the output terminal. Okay, therefore, this is negative cycle. Okay, negative cycle, we are having a constant voltage. Okay, now constant voltage, that is your reference voltage. If we consider it as an ideal, okay, if it is a practical, reference minus cutdown voltage, okay, there will be a cutdown voltages, okay, that we can, in this way, we are going drawing our transfer characteristics, okay, therefore, first we have to consider the positive cycle, okay, positive cycle, we are maintaining constant up to the cutdown voltage, and then it is increasing, and then we have to draw the negative cycle, for complete negative cycle, diode will be in on state, okay. Therefore, it will be clipping the negative pulse. It is going to cutting the negative. When diode is on, entire signal passes to the diode. Therefore, output will be zero. Okay, that means it is cutting the negative cycle. That's why we are going to call this circuit as negative clipper. Okay. I think so. You are clear with this concept. If we have any doubts in this concept, we will see the next concept so that you will get more clarity. Here also same. Okay, negative clipper. Okay, negative shunt clipper with negative reference voltage. Okay, in previous case we have seen the positive reference. Here we have to use the positive reference. This is a negative reference. Therefore, we can observe. Okay, negative terminal is connected to the diode. Okay, if it is a negative reference, negative terminal is connected to the diode. Okay, and it is a negative clipper. Therefore, cathode is connected to the input. Okay, like that you can draw. Okay, if it is a shunt, we may place the current limiting resistance. If it is a series, we won't have this resistor. Okay, the diode will be placed here. No need the current limiting because when it is on, here we are getting a short circuit. Okay, if it is short circuited, high amount of current will flow. To limit that current, we are placing the on current limiting resistance. This is not load resistance. This is a current limiting. Load resistance will be here. Okay, this is our load. Okay, load will be across the diode. Okay, this is our load resistance. Okay, this is not your load resistance. It is a current limiting resistor. Okay, therefore, if we observe the output waveform for this circuit, okay, I think so. How you are going to draw this wave circuit diagram? Okay, by seeing the title, negative shunt. Therefore, cathode has to be connected to the input. Therefore, diode should be placed like this. Okay, cathode top side, anode bottom. Okay, cathode is connected to the input and negative reference. Therefore, negative terminal has to be connected. Okay, I think so. You know that. Okay, short line indicates the negative, long line indicates the positive. Okay, battery symbol. Okay, therefore, negative terminal is connected to the diode. Therefore, this is a negative shunt, negative reference voltage. Now, if we come to the explanation, okay, where input is a sinusoidal voltage. We will start from zero. Okay. Same, you can take it 5 volts and minus 5 volts. Okay, 5 to 5 is your input voltage. This is 2 volts, means anode is connected negative terminal. Therefore, anode is at minus 2 volts. Okay, because negative terminal is connected to the anode. Okay, if the battery voltage is 2 volts means negative terminal is connected. Therefore, negative will be at minus 2 volts. Okay, therefore, anode is connected to the minus 2 volts. Anode is connected to the minus 2 volts. Now, when the input voltage is 0, okay, when input voltage is 0, that means 0 volts is here, cathode is at 0 potential, anode is at minus 2 volts. Okay, anode is at minus 2 volts. Okay, the diode is in off state because the anode voltage is less than. Anode voltage is minus 2. Cathode is 0. Okay, therefore 0 is greater than minus 2. Therefore, a diode will be off state. When diode is off, entire input will be passes to the output. Entire input will be passes to the output. Therefore, see, okay, your output waveform, the input will be passing to the output. Input is coming at the output terminal. Okay, at 0, 1, 2, 3, so on to 5. Okay, whatever the values, positive values, okay, this value will be a greater. Okay, cathode value is greater. 1. 1 volt is greater than minus 2 volts. 2 volts, 3 volts, 5 volts. Okay, similarly, we are decreasing also. 0 volts. Okay, therefore, complete positive cycle. Complete positive cycle. We are going to get at the output terminal. Okay, now coming to the negative cycle. When we are at minus 1 volt. Okay, minus 1 volt. Okay, that is nothing but minus 1 volt is greater than minus 2. Okay, I think so you know that. Minus values is minus 1 is greater than minus 2. Here also diode is in on state only, off state only, because cathode voltage is greater than anode voltage. Minus 1 is greater than minus 2. Okay, therefore cathode is at higher potential. Cathode is at higher potential. Therefore diode will be in off state only. Therefore minus 1 also will come bottom. Okay, we will get at the output. When input is at minus 1, then also it is coming at the output terminal. Okay. When it is at minus 1.9, then also anode is having the higher voltage. Cathode is having higher voltage when compared with anode. Therefore, then also it comes output. When it is at 2.1, I am speaking regarding the ideal diode. Okay, when it is 2.1, the anode voltage is minus 2.1. Okay, cathode voltage is minus 2.1, anode voltage is 2 volts. Therefore, anode voltage is greater than cathode. Okay, when anode voltage is greater than cathode, this will be on. Okay, our diode is on means this minus 2 will be appear here. Okay, therefore, this 2 volts, this minus 2 volts will be get at the output terminal. Therefore, output will be fixed at reference voltage. Okay, when diode is on, our output voltage is our reference voltage. Therefore, negative cycle up to reference voltage we are going to get. At reference voltage, diode comes into forward bias and it will be maintained constant. The reference voltage will be maintained constant. Okay, and then again, if it decreases, again it goes to the zero. Again, we are going to get the positive cycle. Okay, like this, we are going to get the output waveform. Okay. I think so. Now you are clear with this diagram. Okay. In positive cycle, diode will be in off state. Negative cycle, up to the reference voltage. Diode will be in off state only. On state only. Therefore, it comes at the output terminal. Okay. When diode is on, we are going to get the this reference voltage at the output terminal. Okay. If it is a ideal diode. When it is a practical diode, there will be a breakdown voltage of 0.7. Cutdown voltage. Therefore, it will be your cutdown voltage will be added to your reference voltage. Since it is a negative cycle, we have taken minus sign here. Okay, this minus, why we are getting this minus sign means we are in negative pulse. Okay, that means minus voltage. Okay, minus 2 volts, minus 3 volts, minus 2.7. Okay, our when the diode will be on, if it is a practical, means minus 2.7. Therefore, 2 volts plus 0.7. Okay, minus of, I have written. 2 plus 0.7. 2 volts is the reference voltage. 0.7 is the cutdown voltage. That is minus 2.7. When the voltage is at minus 2.7, if it is at a practical, when it is at minus 2.7, then the diode will be on. Okay, and it will maintain constant. Output voltage is maintained at 2.7. Output voltage, these 2 volts, and there will be a 0.7 drop across the diode. Therefore, total voltage is 2.7. Okay, therefore, in this line consisting the voltage of 2.7. Okay, this 2.7 volts will be occur across the output terminal. Okay, I think so. You are clear with this concept. Okay, if you have any doubts, immediately unmute your mic and you can ask. Okay, if you have any doubts. Okay, therefore, output voltage will be fixed at 2.7 when the diode is on. the output voltage will be at minus 2.7, difference plus cut down. This is 2 volts and this is 0.7 in our example, okay? Therefore, it will be at minus 2.7. Output voltage will be at minus 2.7. When it is off, when diode is off, what are the input that will get at the output level? Therefore, when diode is off, the output equal to input. Okay, what are the input we are going to have? That means up to this 2.7, up to this level. Okay, up to this level, the diode will be in off state. Okay, diode will be off state. Therefore, what are the input we are going to get at the output level? At this instant, diode is going to be on. When it is on, the voltage will be fixed. The voltage will be fixed at minus of V gamma plus VR. Okay, this voltage. Okay, that's why I mentioned in arrow. Okay, this gap. Okay, this is nothing minus of. Okay, and remaining portion, this portion will be clipped off. This portion will be clipped off. If you go to the transfer characteristics, okay, same way. First, if you take the positive cycle, in positive cycle, diode will be off. Diode will be off. Therefore, output will be increases. Output will be increases when input is increasing. Therefore, first you have to draw the positive cycle. Positive cycle, complete positive cycle. Output is a VI characteristics. Output versus input. This is output voltage. Okay, V naught. Okay, this will be a linear. When input is increasing, output is increasing. If input is decreasing, output will be decreasing. Therefore, they will be a linear in nature. Okay, are coming to the negative cycle. Negative cycle up to the cut down voltage. Therefore, this line may be a cut down voltage. Okay, this line is cut down voltage. Up to the cut down voltage, we are going to getting a linear. Therefore, this portion also we are going to get at the output terminal. Okay, when output is increasing, input will be increasing. Okay, up to the cut down voltage. Therefore, this is your cut down voltage. Okay, that's why I had drawn the line to this side also. Okay, this is your cut down voltage. Up to the cut down voltage, we are going to having the up to the cut down voltage. This is your cut down voltage. Okay. Therefore, up to the cutdown voltage, you are going to have a linear characteristics. Okay? As the output is increasing, input also increasing. And from the cutdown voltage, output will be maintained constant. Output will be maintained constant. This is nothing but a VR plus V gamma minus. Okay? That is the voltage. Okay? If it is a practical, I have expect practical. Okay? Practical means this voltage will be this one. Okay? This gap. Okay? This voltage will be VR plus V gamma, okay? And it will maintain at that voltage constant throughout the negative cycle. Throughout the negative cycle, that voltage will be maintained constant, okay? This is regarding your negative shunt clipper, okay? I think so you have understand this negative shunt clipper also. Now we will go to the positive clippers once again, okay? We will go to the positive clippers, okay? With considering the reference voltage, by considering the reference voltage. Okay, here I have taken series negative clipper with positive reference. Okay, therefore by the title itself you can draw this diagram. Okay, it is series, therefore diode should be in series. Okay, a shunt means we have to place a shunt. Okay, diode should be in series and negative clipper, that means negative cycle diode has to be off. Okay, is the difference between shunt and series. Okay, if it is a shunt and series clipper, okay, when diode is on, okay, when diode is on in shunt clipper, because diode is placed here. Wait a minute. Okay, fine. Okay, shunt clipper and series clipper. Okay. If the diode is on in shunt clipper, diode will be placed here. Okay, diode will be placed here. When diode is on, total input will be grounded. Therefore, when diode is on, output is going to be clipped. Okay, output is clipped. Okay, when diode is on. Okay, here in series clipper, if diode is on. When diode is on, what happens? This input is going to get at the output terminal. Therefore, output is not clipped. Okay, you have to remember this difference. Okay, when diode is on in shunt clipper, output is clipped. Okay, and when the diode is on, output is not clipped. Okay, in series clipper, if diode is off, okay, that means in shunt, diode is off. First, you see the if the diode is off, okay, in shunt clipper, diode is off means total input will go at the output terminal. Therefore, output is not clipped. Output is not clipped. Okay, we are coming to this series. When diode is off means it is open circuit. It is open circuit means the output will be stopped here because it is a open circuit. Therefore, output will be zero. Therefore, when diode is off, output is clipped. Okay, output is clipped. Okay, this is the major difference between shunt and series. Okay, you have to remember this concept. Okay, when diode is on means in shunt clipper, output will be zero. In series clipper, when diode is off means output will be zero. Okay, simple knowledge. Okay, by simply if you forgot this one, by simply drawing these two diagrams, the basic diagrams. That means if you place diode in series, and if you place diode in shunt, what happens the output when diode is on? When diode is on, okay, simple. Okay, it may be a positive shunt or negative shunt. Oh, leave it. Simply when diode is on, here we are going to get a short circuit. Therefore, output will be zero. Output will be zero. That means output is clipped. 0 volts means clipped, cutted. Okay, output is cutted. Okay, where if it is in series, when diode is on, here we are going to get the open circuit. Okay, it is opened. Okay, it is open. Diode is open. Therefore, output will be zero. Therefore, diode, when the diode is off, okay, when diode is off, the output will be zero. Therefore, output is clipped. Here, diode is on. Okay, by this you can write this one. Okay, simple. By seeing the diagram, we can draw it. Okay, when diode is off, output is clipped. When diode is on, output is clipped. Okay, this is the difference between shunt and series. Okay, this point you have to keep in mind. Okay, when you are clear with that point, then easy you can draw it. Okay. Is series negative clipper. Series negative clipper means diode has to be off. Now series, it is series. Therefore, diode has to be off. In negative cycle, diode has to be off. Okay. If it is a shunt means diode should be on. Negative cycle, diode should be on. Okay. Therefore, cathode V is connected to the top side. Okay. Cathode is connected to the input. If it is a negative shunt, we may place diode like this. Okay. Cathode is connected to the input. Okay, if it is a series, anode is connected to the, because when you apply a negative pulse here, diode will be in off state. When it is off, output will be clipped. Output will be clipped. If you consider the shunt, when it is negative cycle, diode will be on and it will be short circuited and it will be clipped. Okay, like this. Okay, you have to remember this concept. Okay, once if you are remember, then it will be easy. Okay, therefore series negative clipper with positive reference. Therefore, negative clipper, negative cycle, diode has to be off. Therefore, anode is connected to the input. Anode is connected towards the input. When our pulse, okay, input pulse is negative. When you are in negative cycle, anode gets negative voltage and diode will be off. Okay. Therefore, negative cycle, diode will be off and negative pulse is clipped. And it is a positive reference voltage. Therefore, positive terminal is connected to the diode. Positive terminal is connected to the diode. Okay, this resistance is nothing but a current limiting resistance. Okay, when diode is short circuited. Okay, previous, if we won't have a reference voltage, our circuit will be like this. Okay, that means positive series negative clipper. Like this, we have connected. This is our load resistance. Okay, when the diode is on, current flows depending upon the load resistance. Okay. Kind flows depending upon the load resistance. But here we are placing the reference voltage. That means there is a shunt branch here. Okay, if we place directly like this, when diode is on, here the maximum kind flows through this direction. And here we are getting a short circuit branch. Okay, here we are getting a short circuit because here also we have a voltage source, which may be a AC voltage source. It may be in series with this one. Therefore, we can add both the voltage sources here itself. Okay, therefore here we are getting a short circuit branch. Okay, when the diode is on, this will be a short circuit. Diode is on means like this. Okay, and this battery I have placed here. Both will give the same meaning. Both are in series. Okay, therefore here we are getting a short circuit path. Okay, when it is short circuited, maximum current will be flow. In order to limit this current, we are placing the current limiting resistance here. Okay, this is a current limiting resistor. Okay. When diode is on, in that case, it will limit the current. Okay. It won't be any importance in our explanation. Okay, this is a current limiting resistance. Here we are going to having our load resistance. This is our load resistance RL. Okay. Positive reference. Positive reference. Therefore, positive terminal is connected to the diode. Positive terminal is connected to the diode. Okay. Negative terminal is grounded. Now if you go for explanation, when in positive cycle, suppose here it is same example, it is a 5 volts and a minus 5 volts, okay, minus 5 volts, and it is at 2 volts, okay, reference voltage is 2 volts. Then it is connected, positive terminal is connected, therefore cathode is at plus 2 volts, cathode is at plus 2, okay. When it is anode is at 0 level, okay, that means from the starting, anode is at 0, okay, 0 means 0 is less than the, that means anode voltage is less than the cathode. Anode voltage is less than the cathode. Okay, therefore diode will be in off state. Diode will be in off state. Okay, as diode is off state, it is open circuited here. It is open circuited. Therefore, the output will be zero. Therefore, below the reference voltage, you can observe in output waveform. Okay, this here. Okay, below the, that means, wait a minute, here, this point, okay, below this level. Okay, this level we are going to get the clipped, our output waveform is clipped. Okay, suppose this level is at 2 volts. Okay, about 2 we are going to get the output terminal. We are going to get the output terminal. Okay, when our input voltage is 1.9 up to 1.9. Okay, up to 1.9, cathode is at 2 volts, anode is at 1.9, therefore it is less than voltage. Therefore diode is in the off state. Okay. When the input voltage reaches to 2.1, ideal case, okay, when it is at 2.1, when it is at 2.1, diode will be on. Therefore, from 2.1 onwards, we are going to get the output voltage, okay. This may be your input voltage, okay. Therefore, this portion will be cut, okay. This portion will be cut from here onwards, okay. From 2.1 onwards, we are going to get the output waveform, okay. We are going to get the output waveform, okay. And again, it may reaches to the 1.9. Again, it reaches to the 1.9. Then diode will be off. Again, that portion will be clipped. Okay. When diode is off means this voltage will be occur at the output terminal. This voltage will be occur across the output terminal. Therefore, it is at 2 volts. Therefore, output will be fixed at 2 volts. Okay. Output will be fixed at 2 volts. Okay. I am saying it is a ideal cases. Okay. If practically, if you consider, due to this resistance, we may have some small drop. Okay, that suppose there will be some 0.1 drop here. If there is a 0.1 drop, means the voltage across this point will be 1.9. Yeah, because 0.1 volts will be drop across this one. Okay, that may be a practical case. Okay, practically there will be a small drop across this resistance. Therefore, by removing the drop, remaining voltage will be comes to the output terminal. Okay. I am explaining in ideal cases, I am not considering all these drops. Therefore, whatever these 2 volts, we are going to get at the output terminal. Therefore, output will be maintained at 2 volts when the diode is in off state. Okay. When diode is in off state, these 2 volts will be connected to the output terminal. Therefore, we are going to get the 2 volts constant at the output terminal. 2 volts constant. Okay. For this one, if you want to draw the transfer characteristics, okay, V naught versus VI, okay, V naught versus VI, we want to draw it, okay, in positive cycle, below the cutdown voltage, or below this reference voltage, that means below the 2 volts, output is maintained constant, okay, therefore, output is maintained constant, below the, this voltage may be some 2.7, I am saying the practical 2.7, okay. Therefore, up to the 2.0, from 0 to 2.7, okay, from 0 to 2.7, this diode will be in off state mode, because this is at 2 volts, cathode is at 2 volts, okay, we having 1 volt, 2 volts, and 2.7, when anode voltage reaches to the 2.7, then the diode will be on, okay, that is practical, okay, this is a breakdown voltage, okay, 0.7. Okay, then fine. When diode is on, or if the input rises, output is also rises. If input decreases, output also decreases. Therefore, you may get a linear curve like this. Okay, from the cutdown voltage, from the 2.7. That is, this is nothing but a V reference plus V gamma. Okay, V reference plus V gamma. V gamma is nothing but cutdown voltage, 0.7. Therefore, from 2.7 onwards, or we may get a linear curve. Okay. While coming to the negative cycle, in negative cycle, diode will be in off state only. Therefore, output will be maintained at this level. Therefore, it will be maintained constant in negative cycle. Okay, therefore this is your VA characteristics. Okay, this slide I have not drawn the VA characteristics. If you want VA characteristics like this, you can draw. Okay, it will be negative. Negative cycle will maintain a constant your reference voltage, and positive cycle up to the cutdown voltage you are going to maintain a constant reference voltage, and from it is maybe increases linearly as the output increases, input increases. Okay, this is your transfer characteristic of the series clipper. Okay, I think so you have understand this concept also. I will move on to last concept, that is series negative clipper with negative reference voltage. Okay, series negative clipper with negative reference voltage, that means negative terminal is connected to the diode. Okay, it is a negative clipper, therefore negative cycle diode has to be on. Okay, when diode has to be off. Okay, series, therefore diode has to be off. When negative cycle diode off means anode has to be connected to the input. Anode has to be connected to the input. Therefore, now the potential, same example, 5 volts, 5 to 5, if it is a 2 volts, this battery is 2 volts, then cathode is connected to the minus 2 volts. Cathode is connected to the minus, because negative terminal is connected here. Okay, therefore it is connected at minus 2 volts, minus 2 volts here. Okay, this is at minus 2 volts, when the input rises linearly. Okay, up to minus 2 volts, the anode voltage is greater, therefore this will be in on. This will be in on state only. Diode will be on state up to minus 2 volts. Okay, 0, 1, 2, 3, so on to 0. That means complete positive cycle, and in negative cycle also up to minus 2. Okay, you can see the output waveform. Complete positive cycle, because this is minus 2. Here you may have 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, so on to again 0. That means complete positive cycle, and negative cycle minus 1, minus 1.5, minus 1.9. Okay, because it is at minus 2. When you are getting minus 2.1, minus 2.1 is less than the 2. Okay, minus 2.1 is less than minus 2. Okay, therefore this diode will be off. Okay, up to the 2 volts, up to 2 volts, so the diode will be on, therefore output will be increases. Where diode is off, this voltage will be occur at the output terminal. Therefore, this is at minus 2 volts. Therefore, the minus 2 will be maintained constant. Minus 2 will be maintained constant. Where the input voltage again decreases, diode gets on. Okay, when it reaches to minus 1.9. Okay, this is at minus 2, and it is 1.9, minus 1.9. Minus 1.9 is greater than minus 2. Okay, therefore, diode will be on. Okay, again, it stops conduction. Okay. Like this, you will get the output waveform. Okay, I think so. You are clear with this concept also. Time is over. If we have any doubts regarding today's class, you can ask. Tomorrow class, we will see the positive clipper with a negative reference, positive reference, so that the clippers will be completed. Okay, and we may have one more concept, that is two-way clipper, and we may have the transistor clipper. Okay, diode clippers will be completed by this topic. And then we will see the transistor clippers. And transistors, we have two types, transistor clipper and emptor coupled transistor. Okay, with these two concepts, we can close the clippers. Then we may start the clampers. Okay, half of the chapter will be completed. If we complete the clipper, half of the chapter will be completed. Okay, therefore, if we have any doubts,